Moin und herzlich willkommen zu einer letzten Folge Inside the Team in dieser Saison. Die Hauptrunde ist zwar schon offiziell beendet, aber trotzdem präsentiert die Hamburger Volksbank uns noch eine letzte Folge in diesem Jahr. Und dafür haben wir zu Gast Patrick Spencer. So, welcome, Pat.
Thanks for having me.
You have been here in Hamburg since late February, but while you swing from home to practice and to the games and vice versa, have you had the chance to see anything of our beautiful city so far?
Yeah, you know, I've been able to go into the city a couple times, but unfortunately, you know, there's so many COVID protocols right now, and so I'm not looking to put the team at risk. And so unfortunately, I haven't been able to really experience the entire city, but hopefully once the season's over and the weather warms up a little bit, I'll be able to check it all out.
Talking about the weather, what do you think about the Hamburg weather so far?
It's up and down. It's been raining quite a bit since I've been here, but, you know, to be honest, that's the best part about basketball. It's inside, and so, you know, that's what I love to do. And so the weather doesn't have a huge impact on my day-to-day, but, you know, I'm looking forward to some warmer weather, yeah.
So when it's raining outside, you lock yourself into the gym?
Yep.
All right. Before you came here, you haven't played a professional basketball for almost a year. Was it hard for you to find back your rhythm?
I think it took me about a week or two just to get back into it. But to be honest, I've been training all off season. I've been putting myself in position to be ready for this moment. I think it was just more so getting back to understanding the team concepts and understanding, you know, what this team was going to need from me. That part took, you know, like I said, about a week or two, but once I settled in, I felt like I was ready to go.
What was your first impression of the Hamburg Towers team when you stepped into the arena the first
time?
Yeah,
I thought there was a ton of talent. You know, I think when I first got over here, they were on quite a bit of a losing streak. And so my initial impression was this team probably shouldn't be losing this many games. You know, I felt like we had a lot of talent in the locker room. I didn't know what the rest of the league had yet. But I knew that this was a pretty talented group, and I knew that it had a great coaching staff, so I was excited to be a part of it.
Obviously, when talking about your basketball career, we cannot pass about talking about your lacrosse college career. For young athletes in Europe, having the chance to compete in two pro sports is not very common. Why is it a different thing in the States?
I think it just depends on the seasons. Lacrosse is a new up-and-coming sport professionally in terms of, you know, it becoming a full-time professional sport. And basketball was an opportunity that I knew I was going to pursue after college. I don't think it's as common in the States either. I think a lot of people play them multiple, you know, both or multiple sports growing up. But for me, it was just an opportunity that was too good to pass on, and I wanted to pursue my love of basketball.
Is maybe the high school schedule a part of it, that you have the chance to play lacrosse in the summer and basketball in the winter times?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, back home, I played basketball in the winter and then went right into lacrosse in the spring. Unfortunately, in college, you know, the schedule is a little bit more rigorous, and so I wasn't able to pursue them both. Played lacrosse for 4 years and had a blast doing it, but I knew deep down that, you know, once that was over, I was going to be pursuing basketball.
Is there anything you can transfer from your lacrosse game to your basketball game?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think, you know, lacrosse, like I said, is a bit new to most people. But the more you watch it, the more you'll realize that a lot of the spacing is similar. The objectives are the same. And, you know, from an IQ standpoint and a passing standpoint, I think my game translates back and forth between the two pretty nicely. I think that's something that I've been, you know, lucky to be a part of my entire life.
Would you say it's a physical sport?
Yeah, it's a physical sport. I think that part has probably helped me in basketball as well. You know, I think just the physicality of lacrosse, I can bring that to my basketball game a bit too.
After almost 2 months of practice, you made your debut against Würzburg and helped the Towers team to secure the win with scoring 18 points. Sometimes I had the impression it was very easy for you to find a way to the basket. What was your impression of your performance in the first BBL game?
Yeah, I was just happy to get out there and help the team get a win, like you said. I didn't have any, you know, I don't have any personal expectations in terms of points or assists or anything like that. I think anytime a coach gives you a nod to enter the lineup, you just want to do whatever it takes to help the team win. And so, you know, that night it was 18 points for me. If it's another night and I have to score three or don't score, whatever it is, I'm just going to do what it takes to help the team win. That night I had it going. And so, you know, fortunate enough to help the team get a win.
You played 5 games so far, went with the team on a couple road trips before. What is your impression of German basketball?
Yeah, it's a great league. You know, I think if you look around and you see the talent, for me personally, I know a lot of the American guys. I haven't grown up watching a ton of international basketball, but I know the guys that are over here from the United States were really talented either at the college level or played professionally for a little bit in the NBA. And so, you know, the talent level is really high here. It's something I'm happy to be a part of, and hopefully we can find a way to come out on top.
What would you say, who of the American players stands out the most in the league?
It's a good question. You know, I've only been here for a couple months. I think it's easier to gauge if I've watched a full season, but the player I knew who was a pretty big name coming into this was Peyton Siva, just from watching him in college. And then, you know, Wade Baldwin's on Bayern, and he had a pretty good college career and then played in the NBA for some time. And so a couple of the names that really stuck out. But like I said, there's a lot of talented international guys as well that have really caught my eye.
Peyton Siva is a good point. You will face him and Alba Berlin in the quarterfinals of the playoffs this year. It's the first time for the Towers making the postseason, and for you, the first time making the postseason as well. What do you expect of it?
You know what? I think we're just going to take it game by game. You know, it's going to be a bit of a unique format for the playoffs, given the COVID circumstances. But, you know, I have a lot of confidence in our staff, a lot of confidence in our players that we're going to find a way to put together a really good game plan. And it's on us to go out and execute at that point. You know, I think we have a great group of guys. Like I said, I think we have a group of guys that loves being together, and I think that's a big part of it. At this point, it's on us to find a way to go out and execute and make the most of it.
All right. That should be it about my questions. And as well, we ask our Instagram community yesterday after the game and today in the morning to send us some questions for you. And we got one from NK Brand, and she wants to know, you were very excited about a package delivered to the office last week. What was in there?
A lot of snacks from home. I've been waiting on them for a few weeks. And so when I finally got it, I was pretty happy.
What kind of snacks?
A big chip guy. Doritos, some Cheetos, and yeah.
Are these better than the German ones?
For me personally, yeah, they are.
And I know that Zach Kaspersen is really into snacks, so you have to keep them away
from
him.
Maybe we'll share it or keep him away if you want
the most of it. All right, then the second question we got from Helge Hobo, and he wants to know, what was your biggest accomplishment so far?
That's a tough one. I'm more of a team guy. I think the coolest part for me was going to the Final Four with my team as a freshman at Loyola. It's just something that I'll never forget, being able to go to the national stage with my group of friends that are, you know, my lifelong friends. That's something that's really important to me. We didn't get it done, but just that memory alone is pretty important to me. But on the flip side, you know, winning the Towarton Award for lacrosse was obviously a unique opportunity and something that I'm forever grateful for as well.
All right. And last but not least, a question by Hans Brase. And he wants to know, what do you put on your spaghetti?
Thanks, Hans. I put sugar on it.
You put sugar on it?
Yeah.
And butter?
No, I put butter on on like regular noodles. Like if I'm just gonna do like maybe some butter and Parmesan cheese, something like that. But I think he was referring to the fact that I put sugar.
But it's common to me. I had it as a dessert when I was a child.
You did it?
Yeah, it's common
to me.
Thank you.
I don't think it's normal, but some people are a little weirded out by it. Other people get it.
I really like it. So Hans, wenn du das jetzt hörst, ich kenne das auch und es schmeckt sehr, sehr gut. Bei mir kommt noch ein bisschen Butter unten drunter. All right, that's it. Thank you very much, Pat, for taking the time. And then good luck for the playoffs and all the best preparing for the postseason.
Awesome, thank you.